you look at the key to the incoming executive director.
Owing to the ongoing investigations into allegations of abuse of office, embezzlement, causing financial loss, and fraudulent false accounting by the State House Health Monitoring Unit, Dr. Abatorana was suspended from office and consequently ordered to hand over to his deputy. This morning, Abatorana handed over office to his deputy, Dr. Rosemary Byanyima. The private function held at Mulago Hospital Administration Block was attended by the Mulago Hospital Board, led by Professor Edward Kanyesije, Patrick Peter Ture, Senior Hospital Administration Staff, and Dr. Abatorana's lawyers. Dr. Abatorana handed over the keys to his office, official stamps, his official cards, among other items. Speaking during the handover, he noted that during the 11 years in which he has served as the Hospital Executive Director, a lot has been achieved by the National Referral Hospital.
Nationalized Kawempe, Chirudu, and Upper Mulago as independent hospitals during the time when we are still using the same budget of Mulago, and we did not cause any known medical crisis or health crisis in this country. We renovated and expanded all the mess for the interns. We renovated the nursing hostel. We did the construction of the parking yards, which you see, We fought to maintain the land of Mulago Hospital from the grabbers. We renovated the Lower Mulago, which is ongoing, still ongoing from 2014, and associated duties in Lower Mulago. Especially, we increased the ICU beds, we increased the HDU beds, we did increase the refurbishment of beds and others. In addition, we increased the imaging centers and others in Lower Mulago.
Dr. Abatorana said he oversaw the construction of housing units for the first time for Mulago Hospital staff, and that more are in the pipeline.
The oxygen plant in Uganda since independence was established in 2012 under my leadership. Initially, we imported oxygen from Kenya and also depended on industrial oxygen. Dialysis was made simple when under my leadership, to the extent that now we have got about 60 dialysis machines in the country, 26 here, 30 in Chirudu, and 4 which are special for specialized services, which is also present in Mulago. We did construction of housing units for the first time actually since independence of 110 housing units for the staffs that are available.
Despite the achievements, Dr. Abatorana said there are some challenges that he said will continue hindering proper service delivery at the National Referral Hospital.
We have seen challenges in the hospital, especially the budget. The budget has a lot of challenges. The budget is small. The budget of Mulago is small. The requirements in Mulago are too heavy, and the budget is very small. If I can tell you, half of the budget almost goes for the salaries, and another big percentage goes for what we call the pension and gratuity.
Speaking at the same function, the incoming acting Mulago ED, Dr. Rosemary Byanyima, said she will emphasize to the staff to work as a team.
In front of you all, that I'll work closely with the Minister of Health, the board, management board, and of course the most important, the internal customer, the staff, the support staff, the nurses, the doctors, the allied health professionals, and all our other service providers to ensure that there's continuity of service. I believe in the African saying that if you want to move fast, you move alone. But when you move alone, you won't go far. But if you want to go far, you move as a team.
The Health Ministry Undersecretary Kenneth Akira, who represented the Permanent Secretary, hailed Dr. Abatorana for registering several successes for the National Referral Hospital and assured him of fair support in the ongoing investigations against him.
Systems, let's strengthen the accountability systems in place. Let's strengthen the processes so that you are protected on the top. There is already, I think, a challenge as we talk right now of brand. The brand of Mulago seems now to be suffering given what is obtaining. I think we need also to kind of work on that. And I think the best way to work on the brand of Mulago is to ensure that we deliver the expectation of the public.
Meanwhile, the Mulago Hospital Board Chairperson advised the incoming ED, Dr. Byanyima, to ensure that the service delivery at Mulago Hospital is improved. He emphasizes the provision of free and quality health care.
People of Uganda are sometimes the last people to be considered when it comes to Mulago. Because we give free services, there is always that long line, and the human being who comes here is sometimes regarded as an insignificant person. Let that be our focus. Things which are free, even Mulago no longer gives them. I don't know where that thing came from, because Mulago City is a national referral hospital. It gives free services to the public, and it should continue giving those free services.
Dr. Baterana was last week interdicted following his arrest by State House Health Monitoring Unit on allegations of gross abuse of office and misappropriation of billions of shillings. He was earlier arrested by State House Health Monitoring Unit led by Dr. Warren Namara on a string of corruption-related charges. Byaruhanga is charged with 4 counts of abuse of office, embezzlement, fraudulent accounting, and cause of financial loss to government. Preliminary investigations from the HMU show that a total of 28 billion shillings cannot be accounted for at the hospital from the last 2 years. He was released on bond on 3rd March 2022 from Jinja Road Police Station, where he had spent 2 days. I am Rachel Nachwala, reporting for the news.